Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is for the World Heavyweight Championship. It is set for one fall with a 1 hour time limit. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in the event of a time limit draw, our three distinguished judges at ringside will decide the winner. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me take the opportunity to introduce our judges to you, as there are no other three individuals better qualified to judge a match of this importance. Ladies and gentlemen, first originally from St. Louis, he is a six-time World Heavyweight Champion, Lou Fez. And ladies and gentlemen, the only man from New Zealand to be crowned the World Heavyweight Champion, Pat O'Connor. And ladies and gentlemen, only one time in history have two brothers held the World Heavyweight Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, one of those brothers, the distinguished Terry Funk. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the participants. Introducing first the challenger from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 242 pounds. He is five-time World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy, Ric Flair. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Hawaii, weighing 237 pounds, he is the World Heavyweight Champion, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat!
All right, fans, this is what we came to see. Many say it's Flair's last chance. I don't know about that, but that's really an academic point. It's really irrelevant. The chance is now.
That's right. It's right now, but I think he does have to do it. Has Ricky the Dragon Steamboat got Ric Flair's number? Can Ric Flair come back and win that championship for an unprecedented sixth time? Jim, I got to believe that Steamboat does have his number. And in my corner, I think I would have to say at this point, the advantage is to Ric Steamboat.
Collar and elbow tie-up. Flair pushing Steamboat back into the ropes. Clean break, surprisingly. Another collar and elbow tie-up. Lightning quick moves there.
Each time that these two have met, they've been monumental matches. There's no doubt about that. Just both of them terrific athletes. Both of them great competitors. Each one of them refusing to give an inch, and they've just been fantastic, monumental matches. This one has got to be the same.
Each man very cautious as they circle each other. Another collar and elbow tie-up. Side headlock by the Nature Boy. Dragon shoots him off. Good football tackle by Flair. High hip block takeover by the champion. And a deep arm drag takeover to the arm bar. Flair very quickly sets out away from the pressure. Pushes Steamboat back into the corner. Slap. Uh-oh.
Well, it's going to be tip for tat in that corner with that.
I understand the judges are going to keep us abreast of their tally in 15-minute intervals in this 60-minute time limit event. In the case, as you heard, the ring announcer, they go 60 minutes with no falls. The judges will render the decision.
There's going to be a winner, and I think already you can tell the difference that the judges are making in this match. Both of them know that there's going to be a winner. Somebody's got to come out there and win. They're going to go all out from the opening bell, and Flair, I think, is wrestling a different type match just because of that.
It should be a very offensive match indeed with the judging system as it is. Flair on the outside. Referee Tommy Young calling for the break. Flair downstairs with a cheap shot.
Ooh. Boy, can he chop. Oh, hell.
Man, that just sends chills up your spine.
Wow.
Another big chop. Flair likes to punish his opponent. Right hand, straight right, right to the jaw. The Dragon who retaliates. Flair downstairs, Steamboat upstairs. You can hear the flesh smacking. This is indeed the NWA. Ooh, what a chop. Steamboat misses with that shot. but not that one. Flair to the corner of the Irish whip. He's elevated up the top. And neither man giving an inch. And Flair falls right out on his back.
Both of them possessing unbelievable stamina to take those chops, deliver them, and to keep coming back.
Flair falling right on his back out here at ringside. You know, if Flair has any weakness, it might be his back because of the airplane crash he was in the mid-1970s as the judges look on. The severity of that injury is it's a mark in his favor to even come back and compete.
Remarkable recovery on his part there, Jim. Not many athletes can come back and compete at the caliber and the class that he has to go on to be the champion and to be champion for so many times. Talking about that, I might mention right here, Jim, something that the fans may not be aware of. This man, Rick Steamboat, only man to ever make Ric Flair submit.
That's exactly right, with the double arm chicken wing. That was April 2nd in New Orleans in the magnificent Superdome. All right, Flair back in the ring now, and again, both men are somewhat cautious, and I can understand that. Side headlock. Steamboat trying to turn away from the pressure, reverse into an overhand wrist lock, it would seem. Steamboat and Flair both in magnificent condition. Both men rely tremendously on cardiovascular conditioning, overhand wrist lock, test of strength, the determination etched across the faces of both men.
Talking about conditioning, I talked to Flair earlier, and he said that he had taken this match very serious, that he had undertaken for him an extremely demanding training regimen. He says he's in the best condition of his life.
Steamboat with the advantage there, taking Flair off his feet.
Oh, God!
Armbar applied by the Dragon. Drops a knee right into the shoulder. Does it one more time, and Steamboat punishing the champion, or the challenger. Five times champion. We've seen Flair for the bulk since I have known him as the world's champion for so long, and without that championship belt, it was certainly strange. And Steamboat, though, has carried the belt even to a great level with a great deal of esteem and class and professionalism as he drops the elbow on the arm of Ric Flair, and Steamboat now working on the arm of Flair.
Jim, I've been trying to do like the judges. I've been keeping a little scorecard of my own over here, trying to break it out in three, and I'm going to try to keep 3 and 5 minute segments if I can to see who has the most offense, who seems to be punishing the other one more. So far, it's been Steamboat.
Great tackle and a deep arm drag takeover. I don't think anybody executes an arm drag any better than the Dragon. He gets so deep with it, and now you look utilizing the leverage as he works on the arm bar. Look at the position of Flair's elbow is in a very painful position as he rolls away from the pressure once again. Steamboat with the hammerlock on the challenger. Tommy Young, five times NWA Referee of the Year. Signed this all-important contest. Nice reversal. Drop toe hold by Flair. Steamboat reverses, goes behind Flair, comes back with a hammerlock.
Steamboat, I think more than any other wrestler in professional wrestling, he just seems to match up better with Flair, Jim.
He knows him very well. You see Steamboat? Yeah, there it is. I was going to say, looks like he was trying to get him in a half Nelson position. That's exactly what he's got him in. Trying to turn Flair on Flair's back. If it was amateur wrestling, it'd be over right now, but it's not. This is the NWA where we wrestle, and it takes a three count. Flair reversing up. Steamboat back into the arm bar. Pulls on the arm. Big chop by Flair. Oh, he got it all that time. Man, you can hear the flash just... It's just so physical. You can hear the intensity.
It rings all the way around the arena. That's how hard those blows are. What a move.
Nice move by Steamboat going between Flair's legs. Double leg picked up back into the hammerlock, almost in a chicken wing type position. As Steamboat really has the arm in a painful position for Flair. And Steamboat over Flair. Got that leverage advantage.
I don't think you'll ever see any more two evenly matched great athletes like this going at each other tooth and nail. They can do it. They do it every time they meet. This is the way they go at each other. The stamina that they both possess and the conditioning that they're in, it's almost to the point of being unbelievable. great athlete.
Flair grabbing a handful of hair, taking Steamboat in the corner right above us here. Referee calling for the break. Steamboat will give you a clean break.
But is Flair going to let him? That's the question.
That's debatable. Flair with a big forearm. Roll right to Steamboat's head. That was a cheap shot. And Flair with another one. New move in the corner for Flair that we haven't seen him utilize in quite some time. And another big forearm. That's the third one. And the look on Ricky Steamboat's face will tell the story.
You better believe, with the experience that this man right here has, when he sees an opening, he's going to take it.
Those chops are as physical as any singular weapon in the sport. And Steamboat retaliates. Flair with a straight right hand. Steamboat almost down. Flair the right to the downstairs in the abdomen. That's the third one. Behind the head, rabbit punching.
Boy, he's working upstairs and downstairs. He's flailing away at it, really with power blows.
Big chops, and Flair is in trouble here. The challenger falling face first on the canvas, and Steamboat right back to that arm bar. And remember, the arm bar can lead right into the chicken wing. You work on the shoulders, you weaken the shoulders. As the judges, there you see Luthez jotting down some notes. But from the arm bar, it's a natural progression. A hammerlock, the arm bar, whatever it may be, Bob, to go right into the chicken wing.
And I think that Ric Flair's got to be very fearful of that because he knows what Steamboat can do with it. If Steamboat gets that chicken wing on him, a double chicken wing, he's had it on him once before. Flair had to submit. It could happen to him again.
Flair likes to work on the legs as he is the expert, the foremost authority with the figure four leg lock. Thus far, he has not had that opportunity. Steamboat holds on to the hammerlock, working on Flair's arm and shoulder. Flair's got Steamboat up in an airplane spin position. What's he going to do with him? Flair takes him, sets him on the top turnbuckle. And will unpredictable Flair here very cautiously moves away.
He's covering up. He wanted to get out of there. Ah!
Steamboat saw it coming. Big chop by Steamboat. Flying Mares, the challenger out. Nails him with a drop kick all the way over. The Nature Boy was drop kicked all the way outside the ring. Steamboat now ascending to the top rope.
Referee's over, got hold of him, trying to hold Steamboat and pull him back down. It's Flair now, very groggy, on his knees, down out of the ring.
The challenger has not been able to mount the offense that he likes to do, Bob. Steamboat just pulls the referee away. Steamboat has controlled this match from the last several moments. I've got to think, I haven't been keeping any kind of a tab on this thing, but I would guess that right now Steamboat's got to be ahead on points.
I've been keeping one over here, and every way I figure it and every way I look at it, Steamboat so far, in my opinion, is ahead, Jim. There's no doubt in my mind about that. He's taken the action to the challenger. He stayed on top of him. I think, really, at this point, he's delivered the harder blows. And right now, I think it's Flair that's got to dig down, and he's got to get it and come back.
Flair catching Steamboat coming in. Straight kicks to the abdomen. And now backs Steamboat to the ropes. Nice reversal by the Dragon. Oh, and a deep arm drag takeover. And he's gone right back to work on the arm. And I did not have the opportunity to talk to the Dragon before we went on the air. But you got to think that you're gonna not deviate from what brought you to the dance, so to speak. And the double chicken wing worked in New Orleans. Yep. It'll work in Nashville. And Steamboat is using, I think, basically a setup for the chicken wing, Bob, by working on the arm of Ric Flair. He works on the arm and the shoulder, and that's a very important point. Both points of a pressure being applied, the elbow and the shoulder, on Flair. And Flair now sends Steamboat for the ride. Big football tackle by the Dragon. He shows great agility. Oh, and a high hip lock takeover by the man originally from Minneapolis, Minnesota, now living in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Never sell this man short, Jim. He's done it so many times. When he looks like he's on the edge, he comes back and comes back strong.
Somewhat deliberate, he missed with the elbow. But Steamboat, again, getting deep in with the arm drag, taking Flair over. Great strategy applied here by the Dragon, as he has kept Flair off balance and also working on the arm.
Very definitely. He's had that arm. He's got that arm weakened. It looks like that's going to be his plan throughout the match, to stay with that point, to work on it. And if he gets one arm weakened, gets him in a position for that chicken wing, well, you know. And you got to believe and you got to think what this means to each one of these men. This is a championship match. It's all on the line. And they're going to give it 110%. You know that.
And we have our first 15 minutes of our judging. Referee Byron Scott bringing their scorecards over. And Bob, just as you said, Pat O'Connor, Lou Thesz, and Terry Funk, all unanimous. Ricky Steamboat. The Dragon Steamboat.
All right, Steamboat, according to the judges, at this point, fans, is ahead. He's ahead on points, and that could be very important as the match continues and we get further into it.
So the first 15 minutes of scorecard, all for Steamboat unanimously. And right now, though, Flair perhaps changing the tide, changing the momentum.
This man has been in so many great matches. He's got to know, he's got to believe that the tide is so far favoring Steamboat, and that he's got to turn it loose.
Steamboat fighting back, though. The champion of the world showing what he's made of. And they are sacrificing their bodies for the richest prize in the sport. Football tackle by Flair. Did not go to the ropes. Throw Steamboat outside. The Steamboat jumps right back in the ring. And Steamboat showing phenomenal concentration and tenacity. With those chops right on the head of the Nature Boy on the far side of the ring from us.
He's determined he's going to carry it to the Nature Boy, and he's done it since the opening bell, and he's not going to be denied.
Flair upside down, and his leg caught in the top turnbuckle. Steamboat now taking advantage of the situation. Flair may have stretched a knee ligament there, hanging upside down for the moment. Side headlock. Football tackle by Steamboat. And Flair catches him all the way over. And a judgment call by Tommy Young saying that it was not deliberate. That was momentum, he's telling us, Bob, and I think it was a good call.
It was momentum, and he did not sling him over the rope, so the match is going to continue. Now, there's your champion, and he's groggy, down on his hands and knees, out of the ring.
These athletes do not know the results of the scoring of the judges. But it seemingly is as if Flair had heard us say he was behind on points, and now he's really turning it on. And that big right kick, as the judges observe the situation, Flair and Steamboat now on the outside of the ring. Big shot by Flair. He's knocked Steamboat all the way over to the front row of ringside. And now Flair's grabbing a chair, one of these heavy folding chairs. Referee Tommy Young getting the chair away from the challenger. What a chop.
It just cut him a flip right over that metal fencing around the ring. He's got him set for another one. He's going to knock it back to the crowd again.
Steamboat, nailed by Flair, the elbow right into the throat of the Nature Boy. And Flair very quickly re-enters the ring. The Dragon out there with the fans in the first row ringside. Jim Ross and Bob Cottle coming to you. Turner Home Entertainment, we're broadcasting live from Nashville, Tennessee, from the Municipal Auditorium. This is Wrestle War 89. And Steamboat was waiting on Flair. They're exchanging those chops. Ooh, gosh. And now the Dragon has the advantage. Knocking Flair down. Here they come, right around us. Flair comes back into the ring the quicker. And the Dragon up on top.
Just when it looked like it had moved to the corner of the challenger, Nature Boy Ric Flair, it looks like it turns again into the corner of the champion.
He went upside down into the corner, came down the apron, and was nailed with a thunderous judo chop, and the challenger is in deep jeopardy here. The Dragon sensing that he has Flair weakened. A snapmare taking the challenger over. Back into the armbar. He is relentless in his attack. It is sound strategy, well thought out by the Dragon.
He's going to stay with that arm if possible, and I'm sure that he's got chicken wing, double chicken wing in the back of his mind here. And the Nature Boy, I think, realizing, and who knows, it may have been his plan all along at the beginning of the match, the first portion of it, that he was going to try to save a little back. Then it looked like he turned it loose. Now all of that may have backfired on him.
Steamboat with his shin bone right on the bicep and tricep area of the Nature Boy. But great responsibility for the three judges. I'm glad it's them and not me.
I don't think you can come up with three greater people to do that. They know more about wrestling than him.
Steamboat on! He went for the high risk. Flair dropped down. Steamboat ricocheted off the top rope all the way face first to the floor here. And Steamboat was going for the high cross body press. And he just ricocheted five off the top rope. Nothing between him and the mat but imagination.
What a blow he took as he landed. And now, again, the tide of battle changes as it can very quickly when you got two great competitors like this going at it. Jim, I was thinking, we've seen a lot of matches. I don't think you'll ever see a greater match than what's in progress right now.
Flair brings Steamboat back in. And now the Nature Boy. Going for a sixth World's Championship. And another man that has held it six times is at ringside as a judge, the legendary Lou Thesz. Steamboat brought out to the middle of the ring, dropped around the back of his head and his back by Flair. Steamboat, ooh, up quickly. Watch Steamboat get up. Man, he's taking everything Flair can dish out, and it is physical, fans. And the Dragon will continue to fight until there is no breath left in his body.
You'll never see greater determination than he's showing now.
He has brought tremendous class and character to the heavyweight championship of the world indeed. And he and Flair exchanging thunderous blows once again as the fans beginning to taunt the Nature Boy, who always has something to say to them. Suplex and Steamboat up on his shoulder, and oh, that's how far it was.
Wow.
We're looking 6 inches.
Wow.
40 minutes to go in the time limit. We've been informed. What a pace these men have set for this match. And Flair trying to hold Steamboat's shoulders down. You see Steamboat's right shoulder. Flair needs to extend his arm, his hand down to Steamboat's wrist, perhaps to hold it down. He knows that was not going to work, so Flair is going to go back to another offensive move.
He's going to back off, and he's going to do something else here, and that may be wise. I think he should.
Knee drop right to the head, one of the most vicious maneuvers in the sport.
Are you looking now at the man that's going to be world champion for the sixth time?
Well, not if Ricky Steamboat has anything to say about it. Flair had a handful of hair there for just a moment. Good officiating there by Tommy Young. We've had great officiating all night. Should I say all day today here at WrestleWar 89. Flair, double arm suplex, nailed him with it. He's on top now, the legs grapevine, one, two!
Again, about the fourth or fifth time he's been just that close. Boy, you got to hand it to Flair. Never, never have I seen him in better shape and condition than he's in for this match. Jim, evidently it's true. He has trained that hard for it.
Flair drops the elbow on the Dragon. Lateral press, but Steamboat. You saw Flair did not quite get the pinning predicament. As executed as he wanted, he's conversing with Tommy Young regarding the count. I thought the count was just fine. Another chop. And these guys are just beating the hide off each other. Flair misses with a chop there. The Dragon caught him! Oh, I thought the Dragon had him. Flair drops Steamboat over the top rope. Broke first. Steamboat is out. He's under the rope there. And the ropes may have saved the championship for the Dragon.
Flair had that leg hooked, and he could have had him for the count. He had a knee right down across the throat. Bryan still had it there, choking him.
Bob, at this point in time in the match, with this much time gone by, as referee Byron Scott gets the next version from the judges, oxygen, the fuel. Oh, what a chop. It's so important. And we got it. We'll give the results of the judges' decisions thus far in just a moment. Flair's got Steamboat here on the outside. He's got him up. He suplexes him right out here on the floor. Flair has just suplexed the champion on the floor. Terry Funk voted for Flair because of the near fall. O'Connor's got Flair. And Thaz has gone with Steamboat. So we had the first round of voting was unanimous for Steamboat. This time it's a split decision for Flair. We have had four votes for Steamboat thus far and two for Flair, if you're keeping score. So the Dragon, theoretically and technically, more specifically, at this point in time, is ahead on points. Our next judging could certainly change, though, Bob, because right now it's all Nature Boy.
Ric Flair, as we say, fans, evidently has really trained hard for this, in great condition, and he's been coming on strong in the last minutes of the match.
Steamboat up and over. Great move by the Dragon. Great counter wrestling. One, two, and the strength of Flair kicks out. Steamboat and Flair both up very quickly. It's Steamboat with the chops, persisting Flair to the center of the ropes, and he sends him for the ride. Steamboat misses with a chop. Flair nails him. Oh, God, they went over. They both went over the top. And both men lay virtually motionless on the mat here, right outside the ring.
They're both hurt, and they could both be seriously hurt here. That was a long fall, the way they both went out of that ring.
Well, I tell you now, if there's a count out right here, we will still go to the judge's decision. And right now, it's Steamboat 4-2. Flair trying to get back in the ring. No, he's going to come back out and throw Steamboat in. Nature Boy trying to shake it loose here. Works his way around, comes up the steps. Yes, indeed, he is in great condition. Flair goes up to the top, and the Dragon knows this man like the back of his hand, almost like he was sensing that Flair was going to go to the top. And he brings him up very unceremoniously, right off the top. What a move by the Dragon. So now, momentum again has turned. It is Ricky the Dragon Steamboat the aggressor. It is Steamboat on the offense.
And you can say right there again that Flair should have quickly got into the ring. He was a little slow in getting up on that rope. He should have been on the attack again.
Steamboat now opening up on the challenger. And those karate chops right to the head. Each man has taken the best that the other could dish out. Flair sent for the ride. High elevation. Down on his back comes the Nature Boy, and the Dragon perhaps sensing that the end is near for the challenger. Flair backs into the corner. He wants Steamboat to slow it down. Oh, I caught him coming in. Flair, Steamboat goes over. Flair was going for the suplex. Nice cradle move by Steamboat, and we got 2.5 again. Karate chop by Steamboat. Flair just poked him in the eye. Front face locking him. And it's Steamboat, though. Steamboat sets Flair up. Big chop. Flair setting up straddle on the top turnbuckle. It could be the superplex coming here. If it is, I think he can count Flair out of it. A superplex. Flair is this Achilles heel, his back. If it is, he is a beaten man right here. Steamboat up very quickly. Look at the pain etched on Flair's face. And here it comes.
Is it a double chicken wing, Jim?
He's got his feet in the ropes. He did not get set in. We knew he was preparing for it earlier in the match, but Flair got to the ropes. Flair's head rammed into the top turnbuckle. Steamboat now, perhaps preparing to fly. The Dragon on the top rope.
That's a long way to go.
Steamboat comes off the top. And the Dragon has things going his way. Flair is in deep trouble. Steamboat once again will ascend to the top. Here comes Steamboat. And oh! Flair jerked the ropes, I think inadvertently, and Steamboat fell all the way from the top rope to the floor.
He's hurt his leg too. Look at him grabbing that knee.
Steamboat fell from the top rope to the floor. Flair was out of it, yep, on his feet. He grabbed the ropes. That shook the top rope. And Steamboat, my God, I've never seen anybody fall from the top like that. And his leg buckled underneath him as he hit out here. Steamboat, again, if we're counted out, we go back to the judge's decision. And right now, one has to think, perhaps, right now, technically, because of our last tally, it's still Steamboat 4-2.
Boy, he's really hurt that leg. See him limping, and he's not putting any weight down on that leg at all as he gets up on the apron of the ring. He's got to try to walk it off and shake it off if possible, but we don't know what he's done with it, and he may not be able to do it. And Flair's going to work on it.
Of course he's going to work on it. Of course he is. The master of the figure four. And now Flair. I'll tell you something else about Steamboat hurting his leg. As Flair's got Steamboat up to vertical suplex, and he drops him. It's a fact that's going to obviously hamper Steamboat's mobility. And that's one of his great weapons, his agility and mobility. And as Steamboat holds that left knee, the judges very, very astutely are observing this contest.
This is another thing that knee may do. It may set him up for that figure four. And could he stand the pain of that figure four on that knee that's already injured?
I never would have dreamed that Flair would have ever submitted in a match. It's not beyond the realm of comprehension to think that Steamboat, here it comes, here it comes. The crowd is standing. They know exactly what this means. Flair is the master of this maneuver. He has won the world title with this maneuver on more than one occasion. And now perhaps, Bob, as Steamboat is perfectly positioned in the center of the ring, it could be only a matter of time until we see a new champion of the world.
And with that injured leg, can he turn it? Does he have the strength in that leg to turn it on Flair? As Flair has got it locked and got it locked in tight, and this man can put pressure on you like nobody else in that figure four.
Oh, gosh. Man, the pain has got to be just riveting through Steamboat's body. His shoulder's on the mat, and we had 2.5 there. Steamboat's either got to turn Flair over on his stomach, or he's got to get to the ropes. It's that simple. 30 minutes gone by, 30 minutes left in the time limit.
And they've been at this, they've been at it tooth and nail. They haven't slacked up a single bit. It's been 30 minutes of nonstop action all the way. Boy, you got to have two men in outstanding physical condition to do that.
I want to tell you something, Bob. When fans tune in and they see a championship match and they hear 30 minutes gone by, they know it's the NWA. They're not out here posing. They're not out here to rock and roll music. These are two great conditioned athletes for the richest prize in this sport, and they are putting it all on the line. And Flair, he says he's the dirtiest player in the game. He's going to try to dissect the leg of the Dragon right here. And what a chop. Man, you can hear that one down on Printer's Alley out here, not too far from the building here in Nashville.
Well, Steamboat knows exactly what Flair's going to do with that leg, and he's trying to protect it at every opportunity, but there's no way you can continue to fight and do that.
Steamboat fights back. Boy, what a heart the champion has. What character. Woo! Ooh, what a chop by Steamboat! And a karate kick! Perhaps it was out of desperation, but what a move by the champion, whose left leg is virtually useless in the ring. Steamboat's got him up. A slam. The Flair inside cradle. 1, 2. He did it. He did it. Steamboat's leg buckle. And Flair has done it. Flair has done it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner, and for the sixth time, World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Thank you.
champion, the former champion, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, shake the hand and hold the hand of Ric Flair high, and my colleague Jim Ross in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have seen history in the making here this afternoon in Nashville. For the sixth time, I want to present, ladies and gentlemen, number six, the heavyweight champion of the world, Nature Boy Ric Flair. I think also we have to give credit where credit is due. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Ric Flair both competed in one of the greatest matches that any of us, I think, have ever witnessed. Champ, congratulations.
Thank you very much. Not in character for Ric Flair, but Rick Steamboat is the greatest champion I've ever faced. And I'm proud to be here for a sixth time.
Hey, Rick, I want to be the first to congratulate you on being the new world's champion.
Terry, thank you very much. We do appreciate the judges being here.
Hey, Rick, I also want to say that if it would have gone 60 minutes, that I would have liked to have, I would have voted for Ric Flair, because I think that you're the greatest wrestler in the world today.
Very nice. Thank you very much, Terry. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Terry.
You know, champ, it went past 35, 40 minutes. It was nip and tuck both.
You know, I would also like to go ahead, and I'd also like to go ahead and be the first one to challenge Ric Flair to that new championship.
Well,
Terry, I'm honored that you'd like to get in the picture, but as the wrestling fans know, you've been an active, you've been in Hollywood Sylvester Stallone while I've been being the world champion. And we got a top 10. We got a top 10 that the world champion is obligated to wrestle. And that's why we are number one.
Wait a minute, Rick. Wait a minute. Are you really saying that I'm not a contender?
No, what I'm saying, Terry, is that you are a great wrestler, but right now you're rubbing shoulders with Sylvester Stallone and not the world champion.
No. I was just asking. You think that I'm not good enough. You're saying that I'm not good enough, aren't you, Rick?
I'm not saying that at all, Terry.
Yes, you are.
Want me to look you in the eye and tell you that I got a problem with wrestling a guy that's been out in Hollywood for 5 years? It's the bottom line, bud. I'm looking at the top 10, and you're not in the top 10.
No, Rick, hold it.
Let me conclude this by saying thank you. I'm honored, everybody. Win, lose, or draw, Ric Flair.
Rick, please let me just say one more thing. I was just kidding you about going ahead and wanting to challenge you. I didn't want to really challenge you. I was just kidding you. So, Edgummit, let's go ahead.
Let's be, yeah. Thanks, Scott.
Hey!
Funk is attacking. Terry Funk attacking Nature Boy Ric Flair. This is totally uncalled for. He's taking him outside the rail. Terry Funk is a man enraged. Hammering Flair on the outside, out there in the front row of ringside. Flair in his moment of glory. Winning the championship for the sixth time. I cannot believe what we're witnessing here. I cannot believe what we are witnessing here. As Terry Funk snapped.
Jim, and after the champion had already wrestled a match and had already won, he's attacked like this. A sneaking attack by Funk.
He just slammed him face first into the table that the judges were using. Flair has just wrestled almost 40 minutes. He's fatigued. And look at Funk slap him in the face. This was Flair's moment. Oh, my God. What? He's not going to pile drive him on the table. Table over on it. Rick has gone past the line. He has gone crazy.
Look at him! Look at the horror!